Before the Cataclysm, there were no gods on Solasta. No humans either. Then, the rift opened. Some say it was a magical accident, or the work of an evil god. No one knows for sure. The Cataclysm destroyed the old High Elf Empire. Manicallon, they called it, and twisted the land beyond recognition. Now, only the brave and the foolish go there, in search of ancient treasures. But something is happening deep in those Badlands. Whatever it is, it can't be good.
This beer tastes like donkey piss. Not that I'm complaining.
Hope I'm not too late.
Ran into a bit of trouble on the way here.
Sit. Relax. Perhaps you'd enjoy a pint of this obnoxious ale. If you're here for the council job, get in line. Though if this Lord Charon doesn't show up soon, I may go looking for him.
Another round, barkeeper. Four of your finest flagons of donkey piss, please.
So is this the job? Getting shit-faced.
Indeed. You mentioned something about some trouble. Would you care to elaborate?
Well, I was heading down a lonely road when these three shitheads jumped from the bushes, dragged me off, and threw my ass in this broken-down jail. Smelled like some poor bastard had died in there. A strong wind could have took it down. friend.
Thank you.
I needed that. Light, at last. Light, at last.
Nice move, that trick with the wall. Glad you're no worse for wear.
My flagon is empty of ale, and Lord Charon still isn't here.
The council is likely busy with important matters of state, and we are not, so have patience. I have a tale to tell as well. I too was attacked, but I put an end to my enemies with blood and pain.
Let's hear it then. Don't be shy.
you lose.
Thank you. a bunch of namby-pambies. You're lucky you weren't attacked by Sorax.
Shut your gob or I'll shut it for you.
The Badlands are thick with them. Shape-shifting bastards.
Never mind him. He's just another drunk scavenger.
Aren't all drunks basically stupid?
Sorax might be legend, but orcs are quite real. And not just in the Badlands. I stumbled across a secret settlement right here in the Principality.
Bullshit.
I travelled here from the east and left the main highway, hoping to save time by traversing the hills. The views were magnificent, but I should have kept my eye on the path, because it gave way beneath my feet, plunging me into Stygian darkness. Upon my word, this is an orc hideout. The Malador is unmistakable. There they are. Discretion is clearly the better part of valor in this instance. no other means of egress is apparent. Fine. I shall wait until they go. These creatures do hunt, right? Not sure I would have slept so close to a horde of orcs. Orcs have a very distinctive stink.
We should bill the council for all this wasted time.
We've all told a tale of our travels here. All but one of us.
Yes, but I have a good reason for that. It's none of your bloody business.
Come on now, don't be a killjoy. We all sang for our supper. Your turn.
Fine. You want to know the truth? I stopped on the way here to visit an old friend of mine and discovered he was up to his eyeballs in debt with a loan shark.
Sounds like an idiot.
Indeed. He put up a family heirloom as collateral and wanted me to reacquire it because, you see, I can be quite stealthy when necessary. Liam, always thoughtful. Liam, always thoughtful. Wait, a trap.
There you are, you filthy crook!
You? What? You're drunk. Get out of here before I kill you.
Think you scare me? Not anymore.
A grave mistake.
Thank you. Who?
Are you four here to see Lord Karen?
Depends on who's asking.
Well, if you're here for Lord Karen of the Legacy Council, that would be me.
Then we are here at your service, sir.
Very good.
Might we ask a bit more about this quest of yours, sir, if you please?
Well, I suppose it's better if you know what you're doing. What do you want to know?
We hear this is a mission for the council, but what is it exactly?
Dear Moraike, you don't know. I'll try to make it simple, but you know, politics. The council includes representatives of the most powerful and influential organizations in the Eastern Kingdoms. It was created to lead a joint effort to explore the Badlands.
What are the Badlands, really?
Simply put, they are a monster-ridden, chaotic wasteland that used to be the Elven Empire called Manicullen. It was destroyed about 1,000 years ago by the Great Cataclysm. Now, only ruins remain, full of forgotten knowledge, riches, and dangers.
Which countries make up these Eastern Kingdoms?
Simple. The Principality of Masgarth, here, is in the middle. The Snow Alliance lies to the north. The Kingdom of Galavan to the east, and the New Empire to the south. All friendly, more or less. But the peace is fragile.
What are the organizations you mentioned?
The Council is, how to put it, a non-governmental organization, meaning that state governments are not represented to avoid partisanship. Instead, there are delegates from the Guild of Antiquarians, the Tower of Knowledge, the Arcaneum, and the Circle of Denantar. And the Church of Einar guarantees fairness, led by Marshal Beric Sunblaze and Oathkeeper Lyra Keen.
I think we know enough now. Thank you.
What can you tell us about this place, the Principality?
We don't exactly have the time, anyway. The Principality of Masgarth is ruled by Princess Kaiwood Silverflower. We are a wealthy state with fertile lands and the easiest access to the Badlands through a pass called the Copperhead Road. We're in the capital, Caer Kiflin, which was once part of the ancient Manicullen Empire of the High Elves. Hence the magnificent Elvish buildings up there in the High Town. While we don't have a state religion, all of the major faiths on Solasta are represented here, though we tend to favor Einar, the god of valor and fidelity.
Are we going to work for you?
Not exactly, no. I'll be your contact with the Legacy Council, which you will serve as deputies. That's why we need to go there and get you sworn in.
We should go, don't you think?
Very well. Come, gather your things. You're late for your swearing in.
Whose fault is that?
The council's in the opposite direction.
This place is magnificent. Nice gardens. I never thought I'd get so close to the embassies.
Look at the size of this council hall.
So this is what they spend our taxes on.
Look, is that the princess? Wait, is she leaving?
Apparently so.
Then who will administer the oath? There's an oathkeeper for that, I think.
You thought it would be the princess?
Doesn't she lead the council?
No. In this chamber, she's just another delegate.
Lady Keen, the council's oathkeeper, is trusted by all.
Lord Karen.
Yes, m'lady.
Are these your new deputies?
They are, m'lady.
My name is Lyra Keen. Oathkeeper of the council.
Shh! Quiet, everyone.
And I will be administering your vows. Once sworn in, you will carry the authority of the council wherever you go. Your every action will reflect upon the council's reputation. Remember that. Always. Now, please, raise your right hands. Do you, each and all, solemnly swear your lives and allegiance to this council and promise to carry forth our mission to protect our alliance from any who would threaten the common good.
I swear.
Excellent. Lord Karen will enter your name into the council's register. Thank you for your service.
Congratulations, deputies.
Wait, that's it? Stop wasting time. What's the mission?
Well, a motivated deputy. So, the mission. As I'm sure you know, the council maintains a number of outposts to secure the border between the principality and the marches. One of them is the former imperial fortress, KLM. It's held by some 50 troops under the command of Captain Henrik. He sends us weekly status reports, or rather, he used to. We haven't heard a word from him in 3 weeks. Leave immediately for KLM and find out if anyone there is still alive. If Captain Henrik or anyone else is still breathing, bring him back. The council wants a first-hand report.
What can you tell us about this Captain Henrik?
A fine officer. More than 15 years in the Principality's army. He inspires trust, loyalty, and courage. Hence the decision to post him there, facing danger.
Wait, these marches, they're not in the Badlands, are they?
The marches are a no-man's land, between the civilized world and the Badlands. It's outside the chain of mountains that really define the Badlands. We wouldn't send you in there, yet.
A whole garrison gone? There are only 4 of us.
Just find out what happened. Run back if you get scared.
Got it. Though we were hoping for a first mission with more riches than risk, if you catch my drift.
You don't get to choose your mission, I'm afraid. So gather what you need and go. Time is of the essence.
Right, I guess that's that. It's on to KLM.
Hello, adventurers. What can I offer you?
Tell us about your tavern.
The inn? Well, it's not that old, but somehow it feels like it's been here forever. Well, you can meet all kinds of people here, that's the good thing. An old scavenger, a diplomat from the council, a knight, a lord, a beggar. We also have rooms to rent by the night.
Why the name Gravekeep's Cask?
Well, it's very old, from Imperial times. Perhaps a historian would know, but I don't.
We'd like to stay for the night.
Sure. Just walk up to the suite and settle in.
A suite?
It's more like a large bedroom, really. But you know, this is the capital city.
Welcome to Gorim's Emporium.
Are you Gorim?
That's me, the one and only. Welcome to Gorim's.
What do you have to sell?
Everything you'll need for going out there into the Badlands. Food, ropes, torches, and of course, armor and weapons. I also have some other stock like remedies and antitoxins. That can come in handy.
Ever heard of deep spiders?
Deputies, a word if you please.
So famous already. I love it.
You were in there too. Are you a member of the council?
I'm Annie Bagmorda, quartermaster of the Scavengers Guild. We don't have a seat in there, but they all know exploring the Badlands without us would be a bad idea. That's why you should stop by our headquarters downtown. You'll need our services, I'm sure.
Is that compulsory?
No, but you'll find our services useful. Everyone does. Did Lord Karen not tell you?
No, he pretty much stuck to giving orders.
Oh, right. Anyway, we offer plenty of help and advice to beginners like you.
We are grown-ups, you know. At least most of us are.
Of course you are. Well, good luck.
At least she's not another lady or something.
They're tough, these scavengers. Fearless. Inviting beggars to the council? How peculiar.
So what do you think? Should we check out their headquarters?
It's not far, but I've had enough talking. Let's go kill some monsters.
If there's business to be done, we can't afford not to.
Hello. How may I help you?
What do you sell here?
Mostly potions for heroic adventurers like yourselves. I also have recipes for customers who like to craft their own. And ingredients, too. Even rare flowers from the Badlands. Come back anytime. I'm almost always open.
You came.
You picked our curiosity. So, what exactly do you have to offer?
You don't know.
What kind of help do you offer to people like us?
Simple. Now, people like you typically carry out missions for the Council, in the marches, even in the Badlands. Sometimes far away, like Captain Merrin.
Who's Captain Merrin?
You really must be new. She's one of yours. Senior deputy of the council. Anyway, you trek out to some old ruin in the Badlands, kill a bunch of orcs. Well, you're still a bit green, so let's say goblins.
Ouch! You're hurting our feelings.
Orcs will hurt much more than your feelings, believe me. And stop interrupting, it's rude. So let's say you find yourself with a whole load of rusty swords, leather armor, shields, too much for you to lug back here.
Oh, so we're puny as well as green. Thanks so much.
So instead, you brave heroes just clear the place of monsters and draw us a nice clean map. Then we take our carts and pick up every piece of junk. We bring it back, we sell it, and we split the profits with you. We move the stuff, you go off to kill more bad things. Everybody wins.
For a percentage, of course.
What? You could never carry it all anyway. Not in your little backpacks.
Do you sell healing potions?
No, we don't. There's a shop for that.
Well, thank you. I guess that's it for us.
Fine. Feel free to visit us anytime. Or drop into any scavenger camp.
Are there others?
Anywhere we can settle. By the way, if you find Captain Henrik, tell him we're still interested.
In what?
In getting our people to Kaer Lem. The outpost is perfect for us. Close to the Badlands, with plenty of space for our camp.
Right. We'll tell him if we find him.
That would be appreciated. The more you do for us, the more we do for you.
Oh, so this business relationship can get better.
And I hope it will, friend.
I guess we'll see you around then.
Sure. Good luck out there. And don't forget, in the Badlands, always keep your eyes open.
was a lucky hit. You're not coming back.
Deal with it.
Thank you.
kill.
So that's Kerelem.
We're almost there. It's just up the hill.
It's a little too quiet, don't you think?